Hey guys, welcome back to No Catchy Name. It's me, Ella. Today is Tuesday, January 25th, and this is episode number 164. It's also the last video before baby comes. I'm getting induced tonight, so I wanted to get this recorded and up for you guys, because I don't know how long it'll be before I do another crochet video, but there will be some vloggy clips coming out soon because I want to share the baby with you guys. But anyways, I got a bunch of finished objects. I did a lot of stuff this weekend, mostly because I've been sitting around, not being able to move much because I've been swollen and sore and fat and pregnant. But I just took a shower, so my hair's all wet, and I got my little bow on. But yeah, so let's get into it. I got 10 finished objects technically. 4 of them are really small, but they still count. So yeah, the first one is the longest whip I've had recently, so I'm gonna say it first because it's on this page and I need to turn the page. And it is called the Sand Drift Scarf by Cab Crochet. It's a free pattern. Everything will be linked below, but I started this for a watch working on Wednesday 2 weeks ago maybe, but I finished it. I made it a little over 60 inches long because I googled scarf sizes, and I know it depends on person's height, but like the average size is 60 inches, so I went with that. It's a little over that though. But the yarn that I used is called Yarn Art Flowers Merino. The color was 532. I still have half the ball left of that, and it's mostly the dark colors. I didn't bring it in here, it's in the living room. And I used a H-hook, but I started with the white, and it has rows of half double crochet, and these rows are here are extended double crochets. I think in the pattern she calls it quadruple crochets, but it's where you wrap your yarn around your hook 5 times and then you just treat it like a double crochet. You know, you yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through, and it makes it a really long stitch. Really nice. So it started with this like white color, went into white and light gray, and then light gray and darker gray, and then darker gray and even a little bit darker gray. And then, you know, it kept going in that same fashion, getting darker and darker and darker, and right there's where it ends. So it is a good size scarf for like a 5 foot, probably from like 5'5" to 5'8" foot person. I don't know, but I'll probably be donating it because it's got wool in it. Well, I'm not allergic to wool, it doesn't affect me like a paca, but it feels scratchy to me. It's like I'm sensitive to it, you know, I have sensitive skin. But it's really pretty, I really like it. I took a picture of it, I'll lay it out. Try to put the picture in where it lays out. It's kind of hard to show it, but I love these big stitches. I think it looks nice. So I do have about half the ball left, so I thought about maybe making another one of these. I just want to start it after the baby's born. Or something, I don't know. I'm gonna use up all that yarn, but I think it's really pretty. I've been rolling it up like a sushi. Reroll it so I can show you guys. But it's a free pattern. I use H hook, and this is a worsted weight yarn that I used. And you can make it any length you want. It's a really easy pattern. It's a 4-row repeat. I've been rolling it like that. So I'll put that in my box that I put donation stuff in, and once it gets full, I'll donate it. But it's cute. I like it. And it is soft. It's just the wool is scratchy to me. It's a really small amount of wool. It's like 25-75 wool acrylic. So I don't think, you know, it's not like it won't be the end of the world if someone washes it. It might just get fuzzy. But there's that. So now I can flip my book over. All right. The next project that I started was the Easy Crochet Phone Stand by Nikki's Homemade Crafts. Yes. this turned out huge. I know it's a phone/book/tablet stand. And I'm thinking, I have been using it a lot, but I think I might need to make a smaller one because I only use my phone, and my phone's small. I have an iPhone like 8. It's an old phone and it's small. So this kind of swallows it up. But I still use it a lot. I keep it in there by my spot on the couch, you know, we all sit in the same places. I use it a lot, but here it is. And I put the pockets on there. Just trying to show you, it pulled just like the rest of this yarn has. This yarn is Mainstays Multi Pink. I've been making a lot of stuff with it lately because I'm trying to use up the scraps of it, and so it pulled, the whole body of it pulled, and even when I sewed it shut, look at that, it pulled when I closed it. You're supposed to like whip stitch it together, but I just went ahead and crocheted it together because I didn't want to cut my yarn. That's just how I am usually. So it does have like a ridge, but I don't care. But it pulled. Oh, that's so cool. And I got the little pockets here. There's two of them. This is where your phone or tablet or whatever will sit. And when I sit on the couch, I kind of fold it up like that so my phone sits in this crease. And it does work. I use it all the time. I haven't used the pockets yet. But I normally just have my stuff all over the couch, you know, with me. But I like it because I can see my phone. If I prop it up on something else, it just slides down. But with this little thing there, it holds it up. But yeah, so this is a free pattern. And it's also got a video tutorial. So I'll link them both below. I used a G-hook on it. And the, like I said, the yarn was a worsted weight. Mainstays multi-pink. And it took a whole skein. Exactly a whole skein. Like I had enough to weave in the ends. And that was it. So I can't remember how many yards is in a whole skein of that. It's like 200 and something. But I just like it. I love the way it pulled. I love this yarn. It's so pretty. But there's that one. You'll be seeing this color again in a minute. I've been using it a lot. I had 3 skeins of it and I've used it all up except a little tiny ball. Right here's the what's left of 3 skeins. So that'll go in my scrap bucket. Alright, so next with that yarn. This was on last Wednesday's this wasn't Watch Your Wednesday. This was Stitcher Library. 3. So this is a baby bonnet that I made for June for Valentine's Day. And it's called Poppin' Bonnet by Crazy for Crochet Mama. I use a G-hook and then that same yarn, Mainstays multi-pink. So here it is. It's so cute. This is the newborn size. It goes from newborn all the way up to like a year old, I believe. Or 18 months maybe. So cute. So I made this for her to take pictures on Valentine's Day because she'll be like 2 weeks, maybe close to 3 weeks old on Valentine's Day. It's so cute. I love it so much. It even pulled. I think it's so cool how this yarn pulls. Like every pattern I use it on, it pulls. I just think it's so cute. And it's got little ties. So that's that little bonnet. I love it so much. It's so cute. And then I'm going to go ahead and show the last thing I made with that yarn. The last thing I made with it. Oh wait, I forgot to say. This is a paid for pattern. I usually share free patterns. I got this for free with a coupon code at some point. But it is a pay for pattern, but it's super cute and totally worth it. And usually, if designers give away coupon codes, they usually continue to do that randomly. So you could follow the designer, which I'll link below. And she has a bunch of other cute patterns too, by the way. So check it out if you want to. All right, so the last thing I made with that Mainstays yarn is a diaper cover to go with this for pictures. And I just looked up newborn diaper cover. I just typed that in Ravelry. And I found this one, and it was by Crochet It Creations. I used a H-hook, the same yarn. And the only thing I did different is I didn't have any buttons that went with it. So instead of using buttons, I just made with the yarn like a tie. And I'm going to use that because it's just going to be for pictures. She's not going to be like wearing it all the time. And this is a free pattern, but I'll link it below. So I made a little diaper cover. And see, I just put a little tie there. And it's so cute. Let me untie it. All I did for the tie was I just made a chain and then I half double crocheted back into it. So here it is unfolded. And then there's the tie. So this is where the butt would be. And then you would fold this up over the front. And see, there would be buttons here, but I didn't have any like white or pink buttons that were a good size. So I just ran that string through the back of the front, if that makes sense. And then I would just, when I fold it over, I could just put it through the double crochets. You know, the holes that they create. And then tie it in a little bow. So there they are, just through the double crochets. And then I would tie it in like a little bow or just a little knot, just for pictures. And really, this part won't even be in the picture because all there she'll be laying with her butt up because it's the cute pictures, you know, with their butts up. And then she'll have her little bonnet on. So I thought that was so cute. It's so cute. But that's the last thing I made with that. So that was 3 skeins. That's all that's left. I had 3 full skeins of that. I made something with it in like 2019 or 2020. I can't remember what though. I'd have to like go searching. So I had 2 skeins and like a half. And then I made the Swaddle Baby by Valerie. And then I made the phone stand and these 2 things. and now that's what's left. So that'll go in my multi bucket, my multi scrap bucket, for something eventually. But that's all with that yarn for now, unless I buy some more, which I probably will because it's really pretty. All right, next pattern. I made two of these. When did I make these? Not last night, but the night before that. Sunday night, yeah. I made one while I was sitting here watching TV. And then when Devin went to bed, he went to bed earlier that night, I went back and went into the living room and I made another one. So the first one I made was this. Okay, it's the Amigurumi Spider. It says that it is no sew pattern, but I sewed the legs on because I wanted them to be on there nice and sturdy. But anyways, yeah, it's an easy pattern. So it's called Amigurumi Spider by Chicken Soodle Noop. And it's a free pattern. It's a free Ravelry download. You get a PDF, actually. I used a G-hook and I used scrap ball. I had half a skein of worsted weight Red Heart Super Saver stripes, retro stripes. And I used 12 millimeter safety eyes. It's a cute little spider. So you make the legs first so that you can put them on before you stuff it. But I actually found it easier to stuff it and then put the legs on, because I wanted to sew them on so they were on there real sturdy. I didn't want to just tie them on. And then the little fangs, little cheeks and eyes. And the body's one piece. So technically it's 9 pieces. So if you do it the way I did it, you have to sew 8 legs on. But if you don't do it the way I did it, you just tie the legs on before you stuff the body. So it's up to you. But it's so cute. I love him. So I made that one first and then I made this one. So this is the same yarn. It's just different parts of the yarn. Ain't that so cute? This one has fangs too. It just matches the face color, so you can't see that good. But they're so adorable. I'm probably gonna make a million of these because they're so cute. Jesse wants a black one. Go figure. So I have to make him a black one. And these are just, I don't know, I might put them in the Etsy shop at some point or save them for a craft fair in the future. I don't know. But they're so cute. I love them. And it's such an easy pattern. I made this during an episode of See No Evil, which is like 45 minutes long. And this, you know, took about the same amount of time. They came out pretty much the same. They're so cute. This one's cheeks is actually made with the pink from this ball because I had it laying with me. Because the same night that I made this spider, I made this diaper cover. And then later that night, I made this one. And its cheeks is made with a pink scrap ball I had by the couch. It's like a perfect pink or something like that from Red Heart. They're so cute. I love them so much. So I made those. It's a free pattern and it's a free Ravelry download, so you get a PDF, which is cool. And then I wrote down that I made two, but I showed you two. All right, so my last finished objects I made last night, which was Monday night. This is made with cotton. I'm making these for my sister. So I use Peaches and Cream Stripey. And the color is Evening Star, Evening Sea. This is the rest of it wound up. I'm gonna keep making these same things until I run out of yarn. I just, my little cape got floppy, so I had wound it into a ball. But they're just popsicle cozies. I gave her a bunch years ago and they've, you know, been worn out. So she asked me to make her some more for this coming summer. So I just grabbed, I thought this was pretty color cotton, and just grabbed it out and started making them. I didn't use a pattern. I just kind of did my own thing. What I did was, catch my breath. What I did was I started with a foundationless single crochet and I did 15 of those with a G hook. And then I connected it and I just crocheted in a tube. 10 to 11 rows. Two of them have 11 rows and two of them have 10 rows. And then, you know, there is like a jog there because it's in a continuous spiral, but it's popsicle cozies, so it's not like a big deal. And then I just wove in the ends. So I made 4 so far, and it took about around half of the cake because these are little cakes. So I'll probably get 4 or 5-ish more out of this, and then I'll give her as many as she wants, and then we'll just have extra because we have, well, we have like 3 of them in our drawer. We eat popsicles all year round. Those ones in a tube. They're like a plastic bag tube, you know. We just always call them popsicles. I don't know what other people call them. Some people call them icies. But we have a freezer full right now because Jesse loves them. And they're really, they're like healthier kid snack because they only got like 15 calories in them. So we eat a lot of popsicles around here. and they fit in here. I made these ones wider because my sister buys the bigger popsicles. We buy the box that we buy from Walmart is like really skinny popsicles, which I like because Jesse eats them better than the big ones. So, but they're good. They do have a hole in them so that you can move it up and down with your popsicle. Some people put a bottom on it, but I like to be able to move my little thing up, you know, to push the icy up higher in the bag, if that makes sense. But yeah, so I made her four of those so far, and I'm gonna make the rest of these eventually. That's a good like mindless project to do over a baby when she's sleeping. So yeah, but that's just easy little thing. I didn't look up a pattern or anything because I knew the basics of it, but that's what I've been working on. This is what I have left of the I had half a ball of retro stripes, and then I made the two spiders, and then this is what's left. So these are two little scrap balls of multicolor yarns. I will be going into my bag of multicolor scraps to make some sort of project with eventually, or to pull out for little things. And I'm gonna use up as much of this as I can. I'm gonna try to use like all of it for popsicle cozies. And that's it. So I had all those finished objects in the last few days. I finished the scarf, the diaper cover, and these two snakes, or spiders, in one day. That was Sunday night. I finished all those. And then last night I made these four. And then I made this last week sometime. And I finished the phone stand last week sometime. But I got all my whips finished. I don't have any active whips right now unless you count this. But I haven't started it yet, so it doesn't really count. And yeah, so I guess that's it. Until I see when I can crochet some more. But so far in January, it's here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I have 18 finished objects in January so far, which is pretty cool. I'm pretty proud of that. February will probably be less because of having a baby, but I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But I'm excited. I got all my, I took pictures of everything too. I'm being really good at keeping track of stuff so far. But we'll see how that continues to go. But yeah, so now on to life part, because I don't have any active whips. Today's Tuesday, so today I'm going to the hospital at 6, and they're starting the induction at 8. So that's why I took a shower. I wanted to be nice and clean when we got there. We're gonna eat something before we leave. They told us to eat a good meal, so we're gonna actually go get some takeout and eat it. Yesterday we spent a lot of time getting last minute things done. Devin got the base of the car seat into the car. I packed up all Jesse's stuff to take to his granny's today after school. I packed up all of the rest of our hospital bag stuff. We got snacks to take with us for after birth. What else did we do yesterday? I can't remember. We still have a few more things to do today. He's got to take the car seat out to the car and level it, make sure that the base is at the right angle. We got to level all of our stuff. We're going to take off all the trash here so that nothing's like stinky. I just washed all the towels. I've got everything out of the bathroom and the kitchen so that nothing's sitting around getting like mildewy smelling. So I got to go switch those to the dryer in a minute. And what else do we got to do? We have two boxes of things I want to drop off at the thrift store just to get them out of the floor. We moved the living room furniture around a little bit because the swing, she just moved really big. The swing that was gifted to us is big, way bigger than Jesse's. So when we put it together, I was like, oh my gosh. So we had to kind of move the furniture around a little bit to get it to fit in the living room where it wasn't really close to the door because draft. But we got that all situated. I finished going through all her clothes and stuff, getting everything ready. Got her bottles out and everything that needs to be here when she gets here. Yeah, we did most of the last minute stuff yesterday. I'm trying to think if there's anything else we need to do today. I have a list on my phone that I will double check. I separated all the stuff for Jesse to take to mom's. And I wrote notes for everything so that everything's easy for her. I wrote like, she has a spreadsheet. That's the kind of person I am. Explaining his school snacks, how to do his homework, when, you know, his routine, his bedtime and wake up time and go to school time and pick up time, about his vitamins, and his old man costume in case we're still in the hospital Friday. So he has, his 100 day of kindergarten is Friday. So I got his old man costume all together And I'm sending it to her house just in case we're still there. Because I don't know if I'm going to get out Thursday or not. It really depends, you know. And I just wrote her a big old note so that she knows, you know, she can just look at the note. So we're pretty much ready. I'm going to take a nap in a little bit. It's still morning time right now. It's like, when I came in here, it was 9:30. So I'm going to get this edited and uploaded. And then I'm going to come in here and probably take a nap. Because I don't know how good I'm going to sleep tonight. They're just inducing me with that pill. So all that does is dilates you, hopefully, if your body reacts to it. So I could start actively or tonight, but I also could not. So I'm going to just be proactive and take a nap so that if I do go into labor tonight, I'm not exhausted. But I don't know. Devin told me I need to take a nap today. Because with Jesse, they started me at midnight and I pretty much went to labor like immediately. And I didn't sleep at all that night. And plus they come in there every 2 seconds to check on you. And I had preeclampsia, so I had to, every time I had to go pee, I had to tell the nurse and then she had to come in there and like measure it. And put it in that 24-hour thing. And so, like, there's no sleeping when they're coming in there every 5 seconds to check on you. But, yeah. That's pretty much, I'm excited. I'm super excited to meet her. I'm a little bit nervous just because of, you know, what's all going to happen. But I'm excited to get it over with. And I'm hoping so bad that we get to come home sooner. Because it's just because I had a bad experience with Jesse. We were in the hospital for 6 days. And I'm hoping that we're only there for like a couple days this time. But yeah, so I guess that's everything. I'm gonna try to take some clips at the hospital and of course when she's born, but I won't make a vlog until we're home because I have to be able to edit it. But I will post something on probably the community page or maybe a short just random unedited clip. So if I look crazy, just remember I just had a baby. But I will definitely let you guys know when she's here and after the family and all that, of course. So it'll probably be late tomorrow night, Wednesday night sometime. I'll post something for you guys to see. Yeah, I guess that's it. I'm tired right now. So I gotta put my finished objects up and edit this video real quick and then I'm gonna come in here and take a nap and get up and we'll get Jesse later, take him to my mom's with all his stuff and then we will head to the town where the hospital is I'm gonna have the baby at and get something to eat and then go to the hospital and start having a baby. I'm so nervous but excited, you know. It's like a mixture of both. But I will see you guys as soon as possible in another crochet video. We'll see. But I'll definitely be popping up in little vlogs here and there until I am able to crochet some more. I'm hoping I can still work on some little things because I don't want to sit around and do nothing. I'll be going crazy. This little spider pattern is so quick. I just love it. I just love these little spiders. They're so stinking cute. But, yes. Anyways, I might actually, because I have a big reusable grocery bag of scrap balls bigger than this, like half skeins of multicolors. I might just make a ton of spiders. Put them in the Etsy shop. If they sell, they sell. If they don't, they don't. And then I'll just donate what's left. Because I'm sure some kid will love a little spider. But anyways, I'm going to hop off here and get this edited. And take a nap. And I'll see you guys sometime tomorrow with hopefully a cute little baby. Bye, guys.